Hello students, so today we are going to continue with our discussion of the low reactivity of aryl halides. When I say low reactivity of aryl halides, I mean to compare them with alkyl halides. Alkyl halides in their reactivity we have already discussed. One more thing which we have to do is the comparison of reactivity of all these alkyl halides, aryl halides and vinyl and allyl halides as well, and we'll find some interesting results here, and we'll also try to look into the reason for this. And by low reactivity, I this time mean the reactivity towards nucleophilic substitution reactions. So you already understand the nucleophilic substitution reactions. Just by chance, I want to remind you that nucleophilic substitution reactions, they proceed via SN1 and SN2 mechanisms. However, here we are going to simply compare aryl halides with alkyl halides first of all. So let me tell you that the main reason for the low reactivity of aryl halides as compared to alkyl halides is resonance. Resonance you already know, and the resonating structures of chlorobenzene I have written here. Can you see these structures? I have written them taking chlorobenzene as the example. Chlorobenzene, as you can see, is written here in five of the canonical structures. First one is the plain chlorobenzene. Next is chlorobenzene in which the ring electrons, they have moved. And in the next structure, which is written here as structure number 3, lone pair of electrons, which is present on 2-chlorine, moves like this, that there occurs a double bond between carbon and chlorine atom, and a positive charge will result on the chlorine atom. Is it clear? And then this double bond which gets broken, the negative charge due to this will be present on one of the ortho positions here. So this is structure number 3. In the structure number 4, you can move this negative charge onto the next position, and so on in structure number 5 as well. As a result, you obtain a kind of a resonance hybrid. So what you observe here is that chlorobenzene mainly can exhibit 5 resonating structures, out of which structure number 3, 4 and 5, you should carefully watch. They have got a double bond present between carbon and chlorine, along with the positive charge on the chlorine atom. Now, if I may ask you, why at all alkyl halides, or for that matter aryl halides, they show nucleophilic substitution reactions? So your answer will be that because halogen atom here is more electronegative, and therefore it acquires a slight negative charge because of that polarization of the bond, displacement of electrons towards more electronegative halogen atom, and then that positively charged carbon gets attacked by the nucleophile. So that's how nucleophilic substitution reactions, they proceed. Now, if by any means the halogen atom acquires a positive charge, so its negative character will get decreased, which means that bond polarity will be decreased. And if that becomes so, then the you can have proof of this. This actually happens in the case of aryl halides. This will not be possible in the case of alkyl halides because of no resonance, but in aryl halides there is resonance. And although these three contributing structures, namely structure number 3, 4 and 5, they make less contribution, nonetheless they give halogen atom a positive charge, a slight positive charge, and therefore the polarity of the C-Cl bond in the case of aryl halides, that gets decreased. A proof of this can be had by looking at the dipole moment values for the alkyl and aryl halides, you can also observe here that there will be a partial double bond character between C and Cl atoms, and the bond will become stronger, of course. And the dipole moment values for alkyl and aryl halides, they are as follows. It is 1.7 debye for chlorobenzene and 2 to 2.2 debye for alkyl halides in general. So that is quite in contrast to each other, and because of the positive charge which is present on the halogen atom, the net displacement of the negative charge on halogen atom is decreased, therefore bond polarity becomes less, and therefore dipole moment value that also becomes less for aryl halides, which will of course retard the nucleophilic attack. Another reason for the low reactivity is hybridization. Now hybridization, you understand very well the type of hybridization which is present in alkyl halides is sp3, and that is a sort of tetrahedral hybridization. In the case of alkyl halides, sp3 hybridization. In comparison, aryl halides, they exhibit sp2 hybridization. sp2 hybrid bonds, they have got more s character as compared to sp3 hybrid bonds, and therefore they are more electronegative. The bond is shorter, the bond is stouter also, it's stronger, and it also is proven by the fact that the bond length in the case of sp2 bond in the case of aryl halides is 169 picometer, and that for alkyl halides is 180 picometers, which means that the bond in alkyl halides is longer, weaker as compared to aryl halides, where it's shorter and stronger, and therefore this bond is rather difficult to break. In the case of aryl halide, the CCl bond is harder to break as compared to that in alkyl halides. So that gives you a complete explanation as far as the lower reactivity of aryl halides with alkyl halides is concerned. Next, we move on to the comparison of reactivity of aryl and vinyl halides with respect to alkyl halides. Now, aryl halides, they are more reactive as compared to aryl and vinyl halides, alkyl halides, I mean to say. And why is that so? Now, we have seen aryl halides. Now, we concentrate ourselves onto the discussion of vinyl halides. What is a vinyl halide? I can take the example of vinyl chloride here. This vinyl chloride, if you see, again exhibits resonance. So the other resonating structure which can be written for vinyl halide is like this, in which this carbon acquires a negative charge. Mind you, this is the negative charge here, and this chlorine will become positively charged as a result of the shifting of double bond, like this. What happens actually is that here also this chlorine atom acquires a positive charge due to resonance, which will again decrease the bond polarity, and hence the attack due to nucleophile will become difficult. The loss of chlorine will become difficult. Double bond character also will be acquired by the CCl bond, and once again the type of hybridization which this carbon will show, to which the halogen is attached, this hybridization type is sp2. sp2 hybrid bond again is shorter and stronger, and therefore resists breakage, cleavage, and therefore the nucleophilic attack is rather difficult. The displacement of Cl becomes more difficult when I compare them to alkyl halides. This makes it clear that vinyl halides are going to be less reactive as compared to alkyl halides. Now, can we take up the case of allyl halides next? We compare the reactivity of alkyl halides with allyl halides. As you know, what are allyl halides? I can again show the example of allyl chloride here. Please notice that here double bond is there, but the halogen is attached to a singly bound carbon atom, that is again here in this case sp3 hybridized carbon. So in this case also the attack due to nucleophile resulting in the formation of a carbocation, the carbocation formed, which is the intermediate, will be resonance stabilized. So here again the reason is resonance. What happens is that you obtain an allyl carbocation in this case, and halide ion, in this case chloride ion, gets displaced. This allyl carbocation gets resonance stabilized further in this manner, in which the double bond gets shifted, positive charge gets delocalized onto the other carbon. So as a result you obtain structure number 1 and 2 finally, which will be yielding the product with the attachment with nucleophile. You can say that the positive charge stabilization onto this carbocation as a result of resonance makes it easier for this carbocation to be formed, because it becomes stabler, its activation energy decreases, and therefore this carbocation is stabilized, and hence it is formed more readily, and therefore allyl halides are going to be quite reactive towards nucleophilic substitution reactions. But if you compare them with alkyl halides, I must say that the behavior of allyl halides with respect to alkyl halides will be depending on different cases. I mean, it will differ on a case to case basis. As I was reminding you in the beginning, that we have got SN1 and SN2 kinds of mechanisms being followed here. So SN1 mechanism, if I remind you, that is a two-step mechanism in which intermediate carbocation formation is involved. So if I deal with a tertiary alkyl halide, mind you, a tertiary alkyl halide which will be forming a tertiary carbocation, compare it with allyl halide which will be forming an allyl carbocation. So tertiary sometimes becomes stabler as compared to even allyl carbocation because of hyperconjugation, etc., and therefore it is still more reactive and will react fastly via SN1 mechanism. Similarly, if I compare these simple primary alkyl halides which will be proceeding via, see you in the next. So tertiary alkyl halides, they are still more reactive via SN1 mechanism, and other primary alkyl halides, they also may be more reactive via the SN2 mechanism simply because of less steric hindrance as compared to allyl halides. So it's clear that halogen attached to sp3 carbon atom, they are more reactive, say for example alkyl, benzyl or allyl, as compared to sp2 hybrid carbon like aryl or vinyl. So this completes today's discussion. See you tomorrow.